A very good noon to one and all. Today, in this lecture, we are continuing the different optical measuring instruments. So, in this previous lecture, we will discuss about the toolmaker's microscope. In this lecture, we will discuss about the autocollimator and different optical projector. Okay, these two instruments will covered in this lecture. So I hope everyone please concentrate lecture. Okay, so first one is autocollimator. So autocollimator is an optical instrument that is used to measure the small angular differences. This device is very sensitive to change in angles, and which provides a very accurate measurement of angular differences. It is basically a combination of infinity telescope and a collimator. So autocollimators are mainly used to align the optical components and measure optical and mechanical deflections. So the working principle of the autocollimator is as follows. When a beam of light rays coming out of a monochromatic light source is made to fall on a diverging lens and made parallel. To make the light ray parallel, the light source should be kept at focus of diverging lens. After that, if these parallel rays are made to fall on reflecting surface, then the rays reflect back and travel in the same path, but in the opposite direction, and converges at the light source by passing through the converging lens. Now, if the reflecting surface is tilted by an angle theta, then the reflected ray makes an angle 2 theta with the incident ray. Okay? So, these are the different parts of autocollimator. First one is a light source. So light source is used to generate the light rays so that it reaches the reflector. And next, reflecting surface. So it is the surface that acts as a workpiece for the autocollimator. So using the autocollimator, the angle of the tilt of its reflecting surface is to be measured. And it reflects the parallel light rays coming through the objective lens. So, and next, diverging lens. So, the diverging lens, which is also known as a objective lens, which is used to parallelize the light rays coming through the beam splitter so that the parallel light rays reach the reflector. And next one is a beam splitter. So, the beam splitter is used to split the light rays and direct it towards the objective lens. And next one is a target graticule. So the light rays, after getting reflected, reach this target graticule, and the distance between the incident and reflected ray is traced in this target graticule. Okay. So next, micrometer microscope. It is used to see the points of incident and reflected ray in the target graticule clearly and measure the distance between them. Okay, so these are the different parts of the autocollimator. So coming to the working of autocollimator, so in autocollimator, the reflecting surface is the surface whose inclination is to be measured by using this device. The distance between the source of light and reflected ray in the focal plane is measured by using a micrometer microscope. So at first, the light source is illuminated and the rays of light diverge from the intersection point of cross line target graticule, which is placed at focal plane of the objective lens. After that, the ray of light reach the beam splitter, and this beam splitter will direct the light rays towards the objective lens. Okay, the objective lens will paralyze the light rays and the light rays will move towards the reflector. Now there can be two cases. The first one is a reflector is perpendicular to the ray of light. When the light and the light rays are parallel light rays reaches the reflector and reflector is perpendicular to the light rays, then the light rays will be reflected back to their original paths. These light rays are then brought to the focus in the plane of target graticule coincident with the intersection of cross lines of the graticule. Okay, so some portion of the reflected light passes straight through the beam splitter, and hence the return image of the target cross line is therefore visible through the eyepiece, thus operating as telescope focused at infinity. Okay, so this is the case one. So and now next case is reflector is tilted at some angle. If the reflector is tilted at some angle, the parallel light rays reflect from the reflector at an angle double the angle of tilt. So after the reflection, the light rays are focused in the plane of target graticule, but linearly displaced from the intersection of cross lines by a distance of 2 into angle of tilt into focal length of the objective lens. The linear displacement of the graticule image is measured by an eyepiece and a micrometer microscope or electron detector system based on whether visual or digital autocollimator we are using. So most autocollimators are calibrated so that there is no need to convert the distance measured into the angle of inclination. So this is the converted in the autocollimator itself, and the angle of inclination can be read directly in the autocollimator. So we cannot find out with the formula. Okay, the factors which are responsible for the basic sensitivity and angular measuring range of autocollimator are focal length and effective aperture. Okay, so this is the working and two different cases of autocollimator. I hope everyone understand this. So on next, coming to the next one is mostly different types of autocollimators. So in generally there are two types of autocollimators. And first one is the visual autocollimator and next digital autocollimator. So visual autocollimator, the angle of tilt of the reflecting surface is measured by viewing a graduated scale through an eyepiece. So as the focal length of the visual collimator increases, the angular resolution also increases and the field of view decreases. So this is the visual autocollimator. So our next one is a digital autocollimator. In a digital autocollimator, the micrometer adjustment is provided for the setting, but the coincidence of setting graticule and the target image is detected with the photos. Okay, so this autocollimator is used in the lab. It has very high precision and provides real-time measurements, and it is very user-friendly. Okay, so and now, what are the different applications of autocollimator? So this autocollimator is used for checking the straightness of machine tool slideways, and for measuring very small angles, and for checking parallelism, and for checking squareness of column to the base, and for checking flatness of bed plates and surface tables, and for measuring very small displacements, and for checking small linear displacements also. So these are the different applications of autocollimator. So what are the advantages of autocollimators? Means it has very high accuracy. It can measure wide range angles. It is very easy to set up and operate. The calibration is very easy, and it can be used to see the result visually or electronically. Electronically means it's in a computer screen. Next, wide range of accessories and levels are available in this autocollimators. So these are the various advantages of autocollimators. So the main disadvantages of this autocollimator is maintenance required regularly. We have to maintain the equipment in a regular manner. Maintenance is required. So maintenance means we have to check whether this equipment is working or not. So it is a time consuming process, and it requires a sample cutting and processing for tracing by the detector. Okay, so these are the various advantages of autocollimator. So this is the overall discussion about the topic autocollimators. Okay, I hope everyone understand this concept. And now move on to the next concept, which is optical projector. Okay, so first of all, before entering to the optical projector, what is meant by projector? So a projector, which is an optical device which enlarges the image. Okay, so this is the principle we are going to use it in the optical projector. So firstly, this optical projectors is used to check the small engineering components with working standards. So this is the line diagram for the optical projector working principle. So there are the components, various components in the optical projector, like light source, condenser lens, projector lens, and screen. So C, condenser lens, P, projector lens, and screen. So let's see how these components are working together to make a measurements in the optical projector. So a beam of light from the light source is passed through the condenser lens and the projector and the projection lens, and falls those light rays on the screen through the condenser and projector lens. So the workpiece will be placed in between the light source and condenser lens. A shadow image of the workpiece will be created while we placed the workpiece. The magnified image will be shown on the screen. So generally in this equipment, this magnification is up to 5 to 100. So now coming to the working with the optical projectors, general optical projectors. So there is a lamp source. So see this the following diagram of a projector. So general projector. So there is a lamp source. It can be a tungsten lamp or filament lamp or mercury lamp. So coming to the workpiece holding table, it will be stationary or it can be movable with an angular adjustment. There are two lenses are there. One is condenser lens, and this condenser lens uses for collecting and directing the light, and next one is projecting lens. So a mirror is placed to reflect the image on the screen. This is how a general projector is constructed. Let's see how it will work to compare the workpiece with a working standard. When an object is placed in between the condenser lens and the light source, a shadow of profile is projected at some enlarged scale on the screen. This enlarged profile will be used to compare with the working standard. Here, the lens plays a very significant role in the magnification of the image or profile. So, this is also called as a optical profile projector. So this is the working, general working of the projector, general projector. So these applications are, these are used in the automotive industry to inspecting the surface deformities, and in the production industries like glass preparations to inspect the different flaws in the glassware, and it is used to inspect the components with irregular shapes and sizes. Okay, so these are the, this is the clear cut explanation about the optical projector. Okay, so I hope everyone understand these autocollimator and optical projector concepts. So మీరు ఒకసారి ఆటోకొలిమేటర్ కనుక చూస్తే, సో ఆటోకొలిమేటర్స్లో మన మెయిన్ వర్కింగ్ ఏంటంటే, సో ఇక్కడ లైట్ సోర్స్ అనేది మనకి ఉంటుంది. సో ఆ లైట్ సోర్స్ అనేది మనకి వర్క్ పీసెస్ మీద పడినప్పుడు త్రూ ద లెన్స్ ద్వారా మనకు అక్కడి నుంచి ఆ లైట్ రేస్ మిర్రర్ నుంచి రిఫ్లెక్ట్ అవుతాయి. సో అక్కడి నుంచి మనకేంటంటే ఐపీస్ ద్వారా మనం క్యాలిక్యులేట్ చేస్తామండి. సో ఐపీస్లో మనకి గ్రౌండ్ గ్లాస్ స్క్రీన్ మీద ఉన్న వాల్యూస్ని బట్టి మనం క్యాలిక్యులేట్ చేసుకుంటూ ఉంటాం. సో ఇది ఆటోకొలిమేటర్ యొక్క వర్కింగ్. సో ఇందులో నెక్స్ట్ ఈ ప్రొజెక్టర్ వర్కింగ్ ఏంటంటే, సో ఈ ప్రొజెక్టర్ అనేది మనం జనరల్గా ల్యాబ్లో యూజ్ చేస్తాం కదా ప్రొజెక్టర్. ఈ ప్రొజెక్టర్ యొక్క మెయిన్ వర్కింగ్ ఏంటంటే, సో ఫస్ట్ మనకి, సో లైట్ సోర్స్ అనేది ఉంటుంది. లైట్ సోర్స్ కండెన్సర్ లెన్స్ మధ్యలో వర్క్ పీస్ని ప్లేస్ చేస్తాము. సో ఆ వర్క్ పీస్ మీదకి లైట్ సోర్స్ పంపించినప్పుడు ఆ కండెన్సర్ లెన్స్ అవి తీసుకొని ప్రొజెక్టర్ లెన్స్ మీదకి పంపించి అవి మనకి రిఫ్లెక్ట్ అయ్యి మనకి స్క్రీన్ మీద పడి మనకు కావాల్సిన ఇమేజ్ అనేది ఎన్లార్జ్డ్ ఇమేజ్ లాగా కనపడుతుందండి. సో దిస్ ఈజ్ ద క్లియర్ కట్ ఎక్స్ప్లనేషన్స్ అబౌట్ ది autocollimator and optical projectors. I hope everyone understand these two concepts. And the next class, okay, it's about 18 minutes. So and coming to the next topic, it's optical flats. So these are the optical flats can be described as an optical grade glass, which is polished and made extremely flat on the both surfaces. They are used for determining the flatness of various optical surfaces. So optical flats determines the flatness of surface by the interference. So the optical flats are usually disc shaped with a parallel or nearly parallel surfaces, one of which is given on the optical finish. So the materials used for optical flats need to have a very small coefficient of thermal expansion. So the working principle of the optical flats, the optical flats is interlinked with the interference. So the interference is the principle behind the working of optical flats. An optical flat is placed on the surface in order to measure its flatness before a monochromatic light is made to pass through the area of contact. So in cases where the text surface is perfectly flat, there will be no gap between the two surfaces. In these cases where the test surface is not flat, interference fringes will be formed and will be visible in the form of dark and light bands. The elevation of the surface is determined by counting the fringe differences. So the most common constructions are made of quartz. So these optical flats are generally made out of quartz. Some are made of glasses. So optical flats made of quartz are often coated on one side to give high reflectivity. So these optical flats are in the shape of disks, having parallel surfaces. So various applications of optical flats are listed below. So calibration of flatness of various optical surfaces and inspection of gauge blocks and testing of filters and testing of mirrors and testing of prisms and spectrophotometry. Okay, so these are the various applications of optical flats. So in this lecture, in this today's lecture, we'll discuss about these three topics: autocollimator, optical projector and optical flats. So these three instruments workings and applications, we'll discuss about this topic lecture. So I hope everyone understand this concept. Stay home, stay safe, read well. Thank you.